Hello there.
I didn't see you walk in.
I bet you're wondering who I am. I know you're curious as to why I'm writing in this book. Well, let me satisfy that curiosity. I am the great short story writer known as Raymond Carver. Let me get a little comfortable before we start tonight's session. Many knew me as a drunk, but let's clear that misconception. I dropped that addiction and became completely sober, so do not believe when you hear that from others. Well, where should I begin? My birth, perhaps? I think we'll start there. I was born on May 25th, 1938, in Clatskanie, Oregon. And let me just add, it is beautiful country up there. You really should check it out sometime. I spent most of my childhood in Yakima, Washington, and I graduated from Yakima High School. At the tender age of 19, I married the very young Mary Ann Burke, who was 16. By age 20, we already shared two children together, forcing me to take on multiple occupations, such as a delivery man, a janitor, a sawmill laborer, and a library assistant. If you can imagine, this was very stressful on me. Due to our not-so-extravagant lifestyle, my family and I had to move out to California, where Mary's mother had a home for us to stay in. It was here in California that I developed a spark of interest for writing. And well, folks, the rest is history. Just kidding. There's much more to my life. While in California, I attended a creative writing course that was taught by John Gardner, who was my mentor and a major influence on my life and career. In 1963, I received my bachelor's degree from Humboldt University. I took up another job as a janitor and would work nights. I would do all my work that I had scheduled in my first hour, and then for the rest of the night, I would write. A writer's gotta write. A while later, I published my first book of poems, which was called Near Klamath. In 1967, a few things happened to me. My father died. My family and I moved to Palo Alto, California, and I received a job as a textbook editor for Science Research Associates. My job did not last long, because 3 years later, I was fired for my inappropriate writing style. Thanks a lot, Science Research Associates. Fortunately for me, I was now able to write full-time and put all of my focus into writing. I also was awarded the National Endowment for the Arts Discovery Award for Poetry. In addition to my award, I also managed to publish several short stories and my very first book, Winter Insomnia. Sadly, after this year, my life went into a downward spiral, trying to raise my children, going from job to job, and trying to write took a massive toll on me, which is why I began to drink heavily, very heavily. I gave up writing to become an alcoholic. Life was not looking so good for me. Once I started drinking heavily, so did Mary Ann. Sadly, it had a huge toll on our relationship and the relationship we had as a family. I never even spent time with the family. Things just weren't right. Also, we had to file for bankruptcy. That didn't help. Later, I took up a job at the Iowa's Writer Workshop with my colleague, John Cheever. We both drank and never really taught. All we really would do was drink. It became a lifestyle. Cheever was the smart one and left Iowa to go to an alcoholism treatment center. I, however, kept drinking for 3 more years. In 1976, I managed to receive a breakthrough with my writing. My third book of poetry was published, At night, the salmon move. Also, my first major press book as well was published, which was Will You Please Be Quiet? Please? Unfortunately, within the next year, I was hospitalized 4 times for my alcoholism. I had to sell my house and separate from Marianne. I had no choice. On June 2nd, 1977, I officially put the drink down for life. It was time that I became sober. It was needed. It was a turning point for me. I called it my second life. My story, Chef's House, was written all about the past I left behind. In 1978, I was awarded the John Simon Guggenheim Fellowship. I moved to El Paso, Texas to take a job as a writer in residence in the University of Texas. It was about this time that sadly Marianne and I had completely separated for good. But with a sad ending comes a happy beginning, because once Marianne and I separated, I and Miss Tess Gallagher got very, very well acquainted. A little less than a year later, I was appointed professor of English at Syracuse University. Tess also received a job at the university, and then we decided, hey, let's move in together. It will be fun. Too bad is red. For the next few years, I went on to publish many short stories, and I laid low on the radar. All I really did was just put my focus into my work. I probably should mention that I was graced with the Mildred and Harold Strauss Living's Fellowship by the American Academy and Institute of the Arts and Letters. Over the next 5 years, I was published multiple times as a full-time writer. Poetry Magazine published 5 of my poems in their 1985 February edition. Late September, I was struck with tragedy. I experienced pulmonary hemorrhages. The doctors were forced to remove 2/3 of my cancerous left lung. It was the beginning to a tragic struggle with cancer for me. In March 1988, about half a year later after my first experience with cancer, I underwent a 7-week full brain radiation treatment. It was a huge decline for my health. I knew that there was not much time for the good old Raymond Carver. In May 1988, I returned to the role of an admired author, and I was inducted into the American Academy and Institute of Arts and Letters. I once again, for a 3rd time, started battling cancer. Tess and I went to Reno and were married on June 17th for one last hoorah. On August 1st, I said my last goodbyes to my beloved Tess. And on the next morning, I died. Well, folks, it's been great. But that concludes our session with Late Night Chat with Raymond Carver. I hope that you guys have a great day, and read my work.